Okay friends, today I am going to discuss about alternating circuit bridge in electronics. Okay, here we will discuss about Maxwell bridge, Wien bridge and the sensitivity in bridge measurement. Okay, so let's enter into our today's topic. Ongoing there I will explain in detail about that. Okay, first alternating current bridge. Okay, that AC bridge we will tell for it in short. These alternating current bridge are used for the measurement of impedance and frequency. It have types. Okay, it have some types that are, that is Maxwell bridge and Wien bridge. Among them, Maxwell bridge is used in the calculation of impedance, that is inductive or capacitive impedance, whereas the Wien bridge is used for the calculation of frequency. So okay, I am going to start now. First of all, this alternating current bridge, these bridges are used in the measurement of impedance or frequency, and also for frequency selective circuits. Sometimes we need to calculate the impedances. Okay, for that case we use the alternating current bridges. Here the figure is given. Okay, it is a little bit similar to Wheatstone bridge, which you have known already also. In this case there are four impedances, Z1, Z2, Z3 and this Zx. Among these four, two are unknown, whereas one is variable and the next one is another is unknown. Okay, which we have to know. So by the help of known and variable impedances, we have to determine the unknown impedance, resistance, whatever there can be. Okay, in place of this impedance there can be capacitance, inductance or resistance. Okay, under usual balance condition, under the usual balance condition, the impedances are given. How they are given? It is given by the ratio Z1 by Z2 equal to Z3 by Zx. This is the usual balance condition. Okay, this is the usual balance condition. Now we're gonna see what the ratio of resistance of that variable and unknown resistance should be to that should be. Okay, so for that we write this in polar form. While writing this in polar form, how we have to write? First of all, we have to write magnitude and then direction. For magnitude we write in absolute sign, absolute z1 and angle θ1, and then for this θ2, this, for this also we have to write in magnitude and direction in polar form. We write by this process, or for this we can write in z1 e to the power theta. So this polar form is magnitude and direction, or a e to the power theta also, like that term also we can write. So here also for z3 we can write absolute of z3 angle of θ3 divided by absolute of zx angle θx, means that is the polar form of equation first. Now generally in bridge circuit, two impedances are known. Yes, as I have already discussed, among the four impedances, two impedances are already known. Okay, for that we have assumed this z1 and impedance z1 is equal to r1 and impedance z2 equal to r2, that we have assumed here. So equation second takes the form. So equation second, what is our equation second? This, among these there is no direction, directly we have written in terms of resistance. it do not have this in impedance there is no this reactive parts, okay? There is only resistive part in Z1 and Z2. So we wrote for that R1 by R2. For Z1 we wrote R1 and for Z2 we have wrote R2 equal to this have both angle and direction. For this while writing in rectangular form, this is polar form. While writing in rectangular form, we can write in this form. R3 plus jx3 divided by rx plus jxx. We have just written this polar form into rectangular form, okay? From here what we can see in this R1 and R2 there is no angular part. No angular part means the ratio of their angular part is 1. Likewise here is angular part and here also angular part. Means the ratio of this angular part should be equal to the ratio of this angular part, which will give us that angle theta 3 would be equal to theta x that I have written over here. Okay, for this angle, how we write angle? Tan inverse y by x or not? Tan inverse, what is here y? X plus jy means y is this x3. Tan inverse x3 by r3 equal to tan inverse. What is here y? Xx upon x is rx. So this. And from here tan inverse we can cancel up both sides. So here remain x3 upon r3 is equal to xx upon rx. We can do cross multiply also. We can take this r3 over this side and this xx over this side. So r3 by rx equal to x3 by xx that I have written over here. From here what we see, we have considered two resistance, okay, r1 and r2. That impedance do not consist of reactive part, so we have considered them simply as a resistance. And then among this, one is variable and another is unknown. For obtaining the balance condition, if we can make this condition, then we can obtain balance condition simply. Okay? What do we have to do? We have that angular part are the ratio of resistance should be equal to resistance of reactance. Understand? That is the thing. You have to, for obtaining usual balance condition, we have to make the ratio of resistance be equal to the resistance of reactance among unknown and variable. Okay, so from here what you can see, from here we can see that for the balance condition in bridge circuit, the ratio of resistive and reactive part of impedance Z3 and Zx should be made equal. And this is the simple condition for the balance condition. Okay, we have before discussed that Z1 upon Z2 equal to Z3 upon Z4, but if we can make this under the case of two given resistance, then also we can acquire the balance condition. Now that is the balance condition. This is something about alternating current bridge. Now I am going to discuss about the type of alternating current bridge. Okay, among them the first is Maxwell bridge. Okay, let's discuss. Maxwell bridge is used in the measurement of inductance or capacitance. This Maxwell bridge is generally used for the calculation of inductance or capacitance, that is L or C. Okay, and there is figure of Maxwell bridge. You can see in this case the in first impedance there is the reactive and capacitive branch, whereas the reactant resistance R1 and capacitance C, this arrow sign will indicate this capacitance is variable, so they are connected across parallel. Likewise, this Z2 impedance Z2 is equal to R2, only resistance is over there. Likewise, in place of Z3 there is R3, and in place of Z4 the inductential variable inductential and resistance R4 are connected in series. Okay, this is the Maxwell bridge for inductance and capacitance measurement. Okay, in this bridge the resistance was what I have discussed over here, that I have written over here. You can see in this bridge the resistance R1 and the capacitor C are connected in parallel. This R1 and C are connected in parallel, so the impedance Z1. So in place of Z1, what we have to write? We have to write the equivalent of this R1 and C. These two are in parallel, means in parallel combination. While writing equivalent, what we have to do? We have to do R1, R2 divided R1 plus R2. In place of R1, there is R1, but in place of R2, what is over here? Here is C, means we have to write Xc. What is the value of Xc? Or inductive capacitive impedance. What is the capacitive impedance? Minus J divided by omega C, right? Minus J divided by omega C. So while writing here, minus J R1 divided by omega C, and here R1 plus R2. So what is your R1? R1 is R1 minus J divided by omega C. I have taken omega C LCM, okay, directly. Here remain minus J by omega C upon omega C whole divided by R1 omega C minus J divided by omega C. So while taking this omega C upward, and the numerator and denominator would be same omega C, so that will cancel, and minus J R1 divided by R1 omega C will remain over here. So I have directly written this. You can solve this by taking R1 parallel minus J divided by omega C, that will be the same. Okay, similarly, and the resistance R4 and inductor L are in series. So in place of Z4, there are inductance L and resistance R4, which are in series. So the impedance Z4 equals to, so this Z4 should be equal to the sum of this and this. So for this inductive reactance is how much? XL equal to J omega L, or not, J omega L plus R4, J omega L plus R4, okay. So the usual balance condition in this bridge or alternating bridge, okay, alternating current bridge, the balance condition is this. You have to always remember this. Z1 upon Z2 equal to Z3 upon Z4. This is the balance condition. So I have applied value of Z1 and Z4 over here. Other same. What is the value of Z1? Minus J R1 divided by R1 omega C minus J whole upon R. In place of Z2, there is only R2. So I have put here R2 is equal to, in place of Z3, there is R3. So here I have put R3 divided by R4. And in place of Z4, there is R4 plus J omega L. So R4 plus J omega L. Now what we can do over here? Again, we can simplify this, okay? We have simplified that. Divide by J, for this divide by R2, I have made into 1 divided by R2. So this R2 would be downside, minus J R1 divided by minus J R1 divided by R2 R1 omega C minus J equals to, that right hand side is as it was before. I have not done anything change in that right hand side. Now to cross multiply, minus J R1 into R4, minus J R1 R4, and then minus into plus minus. Oh, what happened over here? Sorry, minus into minus plus minus, but here is J and here is plus J. Minus J square, but J square equal to what? 1. So in place of J is minus 1, J square equal to minus 1. So minus into minus 1, that became plus 1, and R1 omega L, R1 omega L equals to, this also cross multiply, R1 R2 R3 omega C minus R2 R3 J minus R2 R3 J. Now we compare the real and imaginary coefficients of both sides. Okay, so while comparing, equating the real and imaginary coefficients, this is the real term in left hand side, likewise this is the real term in right hand side. If we equate both of these, then what we get? R1 omega L equal to R1 R2 R3 omega C. So and another imaginary term, while equating imaginary terms, what we get? R1 R4 equal to R2 R3, R1 R4 equal to R2 R3, or not. So this Maxwell bridge is used either for the calculation of inductance or capacitance. So if we have to calculate that inductance and its corresponding resistance, and what is the corresponding resistance of this inductance, inductor L, that is R4. If this inductor L and R4 are unknown, then how we can determine them? we can determine from here r1 omega will cancel from both sides, so y'all equal to r2 r3 c, y'all equal to r2 r3 c. And for determining r4, how we can determine r4 equal to r2 r3 divided by r1. Okay, if we have to determine the inductance, so we have determined by this way. Again, if we have to determine that capacitance and its corresponding impedance, then how we can determine? If capacitance and its corresponding resistance are unknown, then from the same equation we can calculate that. From here, what we can do? C equal to L divided by R2 R3, C equal to L divided by R2 R3. And if we have to determine what is the corresponding resistance of that capacitance, means that is R1, because we have connected this R1 and C across parallel. So here, for finding R1, what we have to do? R2 R3 divided by R4, R2 R3 divided by R4. In this way, we can calculate the impedance and capacitance using Maxwell bridge. Okay, and another is Wien bridge. That is also a type of alternating current bridge, which is used for the measurement of frequency. For remembering simply, this Wien start from W, which seems like omega, and which is frequency. You can remember like that also, but you have to understand. You have to understand the working. Okay. So let's start this also. Wien bridge is used in the measurement of frequency. Yes, before Maxwell bridge was used for the determination of inductance or capacitance. Likewise, Wien bridge is used for the calculation of frequency. So here you can see the figure of Wien bridge. This is a voltage source, a constant voltage source. There, in place of Z1, there is only R1, and in place of Z2, there is R2, and in place of Z3, there is R3 and C3, which are connected across parallel, and both are variable. And in place of Z4, there is the capacitance C4 and R4 are connected in series. Okay. This thing you have to remember. In case of that Maxwell bridge, there in place of Z1, there R1 and C were connected in parallel, but in Wien's bridge, this arrangement is different. Okay, but other working principle and finding that calculation are almost similar. Only this figure you have to be careful. And this here was Yell in case of Maxwell bridge, but Wien have used that variable capacitance R4 parallel with C4 with that resistance R4, and then done his measurement. Okay, so these things are written over here. In this bridge, the capacitor C3 is connected in parallel with resistance R3. With this resistance R3, another capacitor C3 is connected in parallel. So the impedance Z3. So we have to write impedance means total. You have to write, okay, total means R3 parallel C3. So it's similar to before. I have done directly over here also. Minus JR3 divided by omega C3 divided by R3 and minus J by omega C3 or not. So omega C3 I have directly taken common, and then I have cancelled from upside and downside. So here omega C3 remain. Omega minus J R3 divided by omega C3 whole divided by omega R3 C3 minus J divided by omega C3. So while solving that denominator term, we have to do multiply, and then we have to take that denominator term also denominator upside, and that numerator should be taken downside. So this term will come from there. Okay, and the capacitor C4 is connected in series with the resistance R4. And in the place of that impedance Z4, there the resistance R4 and the capacitance C4 are connected in series. So for series arrangement, what we have to do? We have to directly sum of the parts or the components. So the impedance Z4 equal to R4 plus J divided by omega C4 minus J divided by omega C4. So, okay, again, we have done similarly. So the usual balance relation is, what is the usual balance relation in case of this bridge arrangement? Z1 by Z2 equal to Z3 by Z4. दिस कंडीशन इज ऑलवेज रिक्वायर्ड. ओके सो यू हैव टू रिमेंबर दिस. वॉट इट विल इम्प्लाइज, इन प्लेस ऑफ जेड वन वी हैव यूज आर वन ओनली, सो इन प्लेस ऑफ जेड वन आई हैव पुट आर वन, एंड इन प्लेस ऑफ जेड टू वी हैव यूज आर टू ओनली, सो हियर ऑल्सो यू हैव वी हैव पुट आर टू इज इक्वल टू जेड थ्री. वाट वी हैव कैलकुलेटेड जेड थ्री, वाट वी हैव यूज और वाट वीन हैव यूज. ओके वीन हैव यूज दिस एक्चुअली वी आर ओनली जस्ट स्टडिंग. सो इन प्लेस ऑफ जेड थ्री माइनस जे आर थ्री डिवाइड बाई ओमेगा आर थ्री सी थ्री माइनस जे डिवाइड बाई दिस जेड फोर आर फोर माइनस जे डिवाइड बाई ओमेगा सी फोर. ओके नाउ वी कैन सिंप्लीफाई दिस, वी कैन टेक एलसीएम ऑफ दिस डाउन साइड ओमेगा सी फोर एंड देन वी कैन अरेंज दिस. ओके नाउ वी विल सिंप्लीफाई दिस. दिस लेफ्ट हैंड साइड वी हैव लेफ्ट एज इट वॉज बिफोर इज इक्वल टू माइनस जे आर थ्री डिवाइड बाई ओमेगा आर थ्री सी थ्री माइनस जे. वी हैव टेकन दैट ओमेगा सी फोर एलसीएम हियर, ओमेगा सी फोर एलसीएम एंड हियर व्हाट बिकेम ओमेगा सी फोर आर फोर माइनस जे. एंड व्हाइल टेकिंग ऑफ साइड दैट वुड बी एक्सचेंज डिनोमिनेटर, न्यूमरेटर एंड डिनोमिनेटर एक्सचेंज वर हियर. ओके दैट डिनोमिनेटर गॉन ऑफ साइड एंड न्यूमरेटर कम डाउन साइड. सो ऑन मल्टीप्लाइंग दिस व्हाट वी विल गेट माइनस जे ओमेगा आर थ्री सी फोर एंड मल्टीप्लाई दिस ऑल्सो ओमेगा इंटू ओमेगा ओमेगा स्क्वायर आर थ्री आर फोर सी थ्री सी फोर माइनस एंड जे ओमेगा आर थ्री सी थ्री एंड माइनस जे ओमेगा आर फोर सी फोर माइनस इंटू माइनस प्लस जे इंटू जे जे स्क्वायर दैट इज माइनस वन. सो माइनस वन कम हेयर दिस लेफ्ट हैंड साइड वी हैव लेफ्ट एज इट वॉज बिफोर. सो नाउ अगेन वी विल डू क्रॉस मल्टीप्लाई. ओके आर वन एंड दिस मल्टीप्लाई एंड आर टू एंड दिस मल्टीप्लाई. सो वाट वी विल गेट आर वन look here both of these terms consist of j or not means they are imaginary terms and this is real and this is also real. So real real part we have that differentiated or we have separated that real term and imaginary term while multiplying over here r1 and real term and here minus. So minus r1 and imaginary term means j omega is common in this imaginary term. So minus j omega r1 r3 c3 plus r4 c4 is equal to then this r2 minus j omega r2 r3 c4. Again what we have to, again we have compared the real and imaginary term here also. Now equating the coefficient of real and imaginary term what we will get, in this side there is a real term but in the right hand side there is no real term. So we have to have the coefficient of real term should be equal to zero or whole real term should be equal to zero. So we can this r1 is not zero, so we have to consider this part is zero. So on comparing real term this part should be equal to zero and while comparing this imaginary term both side consist of imaginary term. So first of all we have simplified this and then we have compared that imaginary coefficient. Okay omega square equal to this minus 1 goes to another side becomes plus 1 and this multiply goes to another side becomes divide. So omega square equal to 1 divided by r3 r4 c3 c4. Okay and while comparing this imaginary term what we will get, this j minus j omega minus j omega is common so no need to repeat that. R1 R3 C3 plus R4 C4 R1 R3 C3 plus R4 C4 is equal to and what is in this right hand side R2 R3 C4 R2 R3 C4. Okay so we have opened this bracket R1 R3 C3 R1 R3 C3 plus R1 R4 C4 R1 R4 C4 is equal to R2 R3 C4 R2 R3 C4. So again we will simplify this. On how we simplify this, we will simplify this by dividing both sides by c3 c4 product of c3 and c4. Okay so dividing both sides by c3 c4 what do we get r1 r3 divided by c4. Look here there was c3 so c3 c3 cancel c4 remain. Yeah, r1 r3 by c4 r1 r3 by c4 plus as it was before and there in numerator there was c4 term so c4 cancel and R1 R4 by C3 remaining. R1 R4 by C3 remain. Here would be R2 R3 by C3. R2 R3 by C3. Now again we will separate those terms which have same denominator. That is C3 C3 we will keep in same side. So R1 R3 by C4 in one side and this R2 R3 by C3 as it was before and this plus term goes to another side becomes minus. Okay. So on again we will arrange this. We will take common C3 from both and then we will take this C3 into another side and we will bring this R1 R3 into the denominator of that from. So what on doing that, what we will get? C3 by C4 equal to R2 R3 divided by R1 R3, means R3 R3 cancel, R2 by R1 minus R1 R4 divided by R1 R3, means R4 by R3, since R1 R1 would cancel from numerator and denominator. So, and this was the condition which was found by Wien. Okay, Wien have found this condition, and he have assumed that if we assume the value of C3 and C4 in such a way that its value is equal to 1, and again its value is equal to the ratio of R4 and R3, and if both are equal, if the ratio of R3 by R4 and C3 and C4 and R4 by R3 is same, then what would be our result? Same and both equal to 1, then what would be? If C3 by C4 equal to R4 by R3 equal to 1, then we will get R2 by R1 equal to 2. R2 by R1 equal to 2. And in this case, from here what you can see? R3 C3 equal to R4 C4 also or not? If we do cross multiply over here. So, we have before found the expression of frequency here, omega square equal to 1 divided by R3 R4 C3 C4. But if we take that condition, this C3 by C4 equal to R4 by R3, then the product of C3 and R3 would be equal to the product of R4 and C4. So in place of R4 C4, we can put R3 C3. So here we can put omega square equal to 1 divided by R3 C3 whole square. So square square would be cancelled, and omega equal to 1 divided by R3 C3. And we already know this omega equal to 2 pi into frequency. So f equal to 1 divided by 2 pi R3 C3, that would be the frequency. And f equal to 1 divided by 2 pi R3 C3. This equation will gives the expression for the frequency of the AC bridge, which was calculated by Wien. Okay, this is the Wien bridge. And the last thing remaining in this portion is that sensitivity in the measurement of bridge. Okay, this sensitivity means if that unknown impedance is varied by some factor, then under stable condition the detector terminal will detect zero voltage, but if the unknown impedance is varied by some factor, then that may bring some voltage detection in the detector terminal, and due to the variation of this is impedance, unknown impedance by small factor, how much voltage is appeared across that detector terminal, that we will study in this section. Okay, so let's enter here also. Sensitivity is the unbalanced voltage appearing across the detector terminal when the variable resistance is varied by small factor delta. Okay, when we vary the unknown, we already know that in this bridge two impedance should be known and one should be variable and the next is unknown. Okay, so among them, in this case the impedance across the variable impedance is varied by a small factor delta. Okay, so let the impedance Z1 be variable impedance. In this case we have assumed this Z1 is variable impedance, means by first of all it would be Z1 under balance condition. So while violating that balance condition, we would change it by a factor of delta and we would make it Z1 plus delta Z1. Okay, that is our assumption. If it is varied by a factor delta to Z1 plus delta Z1, after varying it would be Z1 plus delta Z1, then the balance condition would be distracted. So the balance condition would not be long lasting, it would distort, and the voltage is appeared across the detector terminal. Yeah, during the balance condition there would be no detection of voltage, that would be zero. But if we vary this balance condition, or if we vary this variable impedance, then after that we can find some of the some of the voltage appearing across this detector terminal. Okay, this is the symbol of headphone detector device. This is so The usual balance condition is, yes, as we have discussed before also, the balance condition in this bridge measurements is Z1 by Z2 equal to Z3 by Z4. Okay. After the impedance is varied, the current across the loop EBCDE is given as. So after varying this impedance across Z1, the current also would vary. Okay. So if we look in this loop E, B, C, D, E, what we will get? Here is impedance is Z1 plus del Z1 after distortion. Here is told after distortion, after the impedance is varied, means that in place of Z1 we have to write Z1 plus delta Z1. Current these two would be in series. Okay? In series the current would be same. For that I1 equal to here applied voltage is E, E divided by R, in place of R what are there? Z1 plus del Z1 plus Z3. So I1 equal to E divided by Z1 plus del Z1 plus Z3, that would be E divided by Z1 plus del Z1 plus R3. We have done I equal to V by R. Okay? That simply we have done. Likewise, we can calculate the value of current in this downward terminal also. E, B, A, D, E also we can do calculation similarly. Also the current across the loop E, B, A, D, E. As I have told before, E, B, A, D, E means this downward loop. What would be the current over here? Here also the in they two are in parallel, so the voltage is same. Not in parallel, voltage would be same. So I2 equal to E divided by what would be resistance over here? Z2 and Z4. Parallel means you have to do addition. I2 equal to E divided by Z2 plus Z4. Okay. I2 equal to E divided by Z2 plus Z4. Okay. So again in loop ABCA by using Kirchhoff's voltage law. But our aim is to calculate what? Our aim is to calculate this sensitivity voltage. So how we can calculate this? If we apply Kirchhoff voltage law at this terminal. Any terminal we can calculate here also, but if we calculate over here from here to here, what we can do? This is greater, so this plus this equal to this we should do. Voltage across this terminal equal to this plus this, or what is the voltage across this terminal? I1 Z1 plus del Z1, or not? I1 Z1 plus del Z1. Minus ES equal to I2 Z2, but our aim is to calculate ES, so ES would be equal to I1 Z1 plus del Z1 minus I2 Z2, because this have increased by some factor, so this we have become greater. So while solving, we have for calculating this, we have to subtract from greater, okay? Because in balance condition both were equal, but after it increased, this become higher, so we have to subtract from higher to lower that also. In this way you can remember. So ES equal to I1 Z1 plus del Z1 minus I2 Z2. Okay. Now from these three equations, what we can do? We can apply the value of I1 from equation 1 and I2 from equation 2 in equation 3. Then we will get ES equal to, in place of I1 we will get the term containing E. Right? E divided by what we have calculated? E divided by Z1 plus del Z1 plus Z3. Minus I in place of I2 E divided by Z2 plus Z4 Z2. From both term we can calculate E common, so and after taking that E common we will take in denominator from this side to this side cross multiply, so ES by E equal to that numerator remains Z1 plus del Z1 divided by Z1 plus del Z1 plus Z3 from this Z1 plus del Z1 plus Z3 from here, and then this minus as it is from here Z2 from here, and then that E goes to the other side, remain only Z2 plus Z4, Z2 plus Z4, that remain over here. Now we have taken LCM, okay, take LCM these two, ES by E as it was before is equal to LCM is both because they are different, so multiply this by this and this by this. On multiplying what do we get? Z1 Z2 plus Z1 Z4 plus del Z1 Z2 plus del Z1 Z4 in this. And then here is minus, so minus Z1 Z2 minus del Z1 Z2 minus z2 z3 divided by this denominator term. Again here you can see the common terms are been cancelled. z1 z2 minus and plus cancel. Likewise minus delta z1 z2 and plus delta z1 z2 cancel. z1 z4 here is minus z2 z3. But for balance condition, look from here. From balance condition, what we can see, z1 by z2 equal to z3 by z4. From here, if we do cross multiply, then z1 z4 equal to z2 z3. So we have applied this case over here, z2 z3, and this z1 z4 also we have cancelled. As their ratio are equal, so by cross multiplying, we can cancel this also. So here remains only what remain over here, delta z1 z4 only remain. Delta z1 z4 remain. And from denominator everything remain. Here we have used balance condition. Okay, so after doing this, what we can do? But this factor delta z1 is this delta is very small than z1. Okay, so we can neglect this term also from denominator. In place of addition we can neglect, but in place of multiply we cannot neglect that. So from denominator we can neglect. Since delta z1 is very less than z1, so it becomes s by e equal to, okay, from denominator we have excluded that term containing delta. Delta z1 divided by z1 plus z3, z2 plus z4, that remains e. Delta z1 z4, z1 plus z3, z2 plus z4. Okay. Now again if we assume this z1 upon z3, here is z1, okay, if we that balance condition, from balance condition there was z1 upon z2 equal to z3 upon z4. If we exchange that z2 and z3, what we will get? Z1 upon z3 equal to z2 upon z4 are not, and they are simply called, sorry, and if we assume both of these equal in magnitude, these factors or this ratio, and both are equal to A, this A will represent bridge arm. Okay, bridge arm. So if both of them would be equal to A, then what we will get from over here? That is assumption. This assumption have been made by someone and all are repeating this. In theory you have to remember this thing. So after using this, what we will get in place of equation? I mean, this left hand side remain as it is, equals to delta z1 plus z3, and this numerator goes to downside, so z1 cancel or not. First, for this we will take only z1 downside. Okay, z1 divided by z1 plus z3 divided by z1 will make, so here 1 plus z3 by z1 would be, in place of z3 by z1 we have to put 1 by a, since z1 by z3 equal to a. So 1 plus 1 by a here would be here delta, and in place of this z4, if we will take downside, then z2 divided by z4 plus z4 divided by z4, that will be 1, and z2 divided by z4 equal to a, 1 plus a delta 1 plus a into 1 plus 1 by a. If we take here a LCM, then 1 plus a 1 plus a, and delta i divided by 1 plus a square. From there we get this term, and if we take this E into another side, then this ES is the voltage that is calculated across the detector or not, across the detector when we have varied that variable impedance by a little factor of delta. Okay, so in this way we have calculated sensitivity voltage, or sensitivity, or that is unbalanced voltage, equal to delta AE divided by 1 plus A square. Okay. This is the required expression for voltage appeared across the detector terminal during unbalanced condition for constant applied voltage. In this case, this applied voltage is considered to be constant. Okay, constant it is considered, and is a function of bridge arm element A, and this sensitivity voltage is function of this A. This A is simply called as bridge arm element. Okay. It is called bridge arm element. For this case, maximum voltage appear at this sensitivity voltage appears at A equal to 1. If we consider this E constant, and then If we vary, keep on varying this, then maximum voltage would appear at A equal to 1. Okay. And another case is there, if this E is infinite, and then this the factor Z1 by Z3 is also infinite, then maximum this sensitivity voltage is appeared at the value of A equal to 0.02. This is theoretical thing. Okay? These two are the theoretical cases. This we can calculate by solving this, or we can minimize this E as with respect to A only. For that we can take first derivative of this, and if we consider that equal to 0, then we will get this value. But this second one is theoretical value. Okay, this much for today. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe my YouTube channel. Okay, bye.